Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Policenauts Blind for the Sega Saturn. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, continuing our readings of the glossary. Yep, that's pretty much all we're going to be doing this episode. Same as the last episode. Now starting information and communications. Oh, this is short though, look at that. Not too many entries. 3D data code. A holographic data encoding method that allows for the storage of larger amounts of data than previous data processing techniques by adding a Z-axis to a traditional 2D barcode. An example of its use is the inclusion of the license plates on BCP's police cars. There are sensors located at various points around Beyond Coast that read these data codes and can use them to determine a vehicle's model and location, among other data, even during times of electronic interference. Beyond Coast Organ Distribution Network. BCODN, huh? A network enabling the registration and exchange of information related to all aspects of organ transplantation, such as donor and recipient blood types. Established in 2015 in response to the dawn of mass organ donation, which includes hearts, livers, kidneys, corneas, joints, bones, and bone marrow. Burst Line. I think we've recently heard about this. A private communications terminal that utilizes encrypted data and burst transmission. Oh, we're talking about the video phones with this, yeah. A burst line compresses and encrypts information in real time, transmits it, and then decrypts and uncompresses it in real time, with virtually no time lag between the sender and the receiver. Nearly all audio communication systems employ this method of coded communication. The world on the verge of yet another information explosion. In order to maintain a fast processing speed, video or images are not usually sent. Television stations such as BBC have set up their own burst lines as a means of obtaining information from confidential sources, and many businesses and individuals also use their own such network to collect information rather than any public network. Contactless ticket. A ticket card containing an IC chip with a radio transmitter that allows the user to pass through a turnstile at a linear railway station without having to insert the card into a machine. A card reader reads the ticket even when inside the user's pocket or handbag, recording where the user entered and exited the train system. All BCP police badges are compatible with this system, allowing officers to freely move about the colony. Makes sense? Informed consent. The information a doctor is required to convey to the patient regarding a diagnosis and treatment. They must ensure that the patient understands and agrees to a course of treatment according to the following principles. 1. Inform the patient of the current condition and the diagnosis. 2. Inform the patient in terms they can understand the details and goals of any procedure deemed necessary for their treatment. 3. Explain any risks of a treatment. 4. Explain the success rate of a treatment. 5. Go over any other treatment methods applicable to the patient's condition, if they exist. 6. Inform the patient of the prognosis if they reject any form of treatment discussed. They must not simply tell them this information, but ensure the patient understands it. This doctrine is built on the idea that the relationship between a doctor and their patient is based on mutual agreement, not one where a patient must blindly obey their doctor regardless of the situation. Radio-controlled watch. A wristwatch that automatically makes daily corrections to its time through an ultra-sensitive miniature antenna that receives a radio signal from an atomic clock. Its time base will fluctuate by 1 second, by only 1 second every 10,000 years. If a signal is momentarily unavailable, the watch automatically switches over to a time-based oscillator to maintain time. Found mainly on Earth, it is rarely used in space, where constant cosmic ray bombardment interferes with its reception. Damn those cosmic rays. The Fantastic Four can tell you all about it. T-Gear 99. The Tokugawa Group's internal network terminal, connected by plastic optical fiber to the Tokugawa's building supercomputer. Hallelujah! Really? The Tokugawa Network, or Tokugawa Net, is composed primarily of all the T-Gear 99s in operation. In order to access Tokugawa Net, one needs to, I guess I'm going to need to do this at some point, or have this stuff. 1. Possess a Tokugawa ID card for passing an ID check. 2. pass a passcode check. The passcode check uses a proprietary family crest format said to be extremely difficult for a non-Tokugawa group employee to pass. Tokugawa Net offers such services as 1. Email file sharing, a BBS, and a remote accessing computing. Let me guess. BBS stands for Beyond Bulletin Service. 2. Multifunction search engines such as Sodiaki, Gopher, and Raptor. Oh my god, Gopher? Really? I remember that. Holy crap. 3. People databases such as Whois. This is like ancient stuff. 4. A business database containing various information such as reports and memoranda. 5. Confidential financial services. Furthermore, information on employees of Tokugawa businesses, as well as the families of employees, can only be obtained through Tokugawa Net. How many times am I going to have to say Tokugawa? It is also possible to view information from outside the network through the terminal's disk drive. The media it uses may appear to be old-fashioned 12-centimeter CD-ROMs, but they are actually phase-change optical disks made from germanium, antimony, tellurium. One disk boasts 5.12 terabytes of storage, well, that's all, with the data read not by a laser, but by charging a needle containing an atomic force microscope with a 0.5 volt electric pulse. Say what? Combining an archaic media format with the latest in super high density storage technology virtually eliminates the possibility of an information leak should a disk fall outside company hands. Almost all confidential information distributed within the Tokugawa group is recorded on this type of disk. For security reasons, the T-Gear 99 is not made available to the public. I predict we're going to be able to get into it. And finally, for this segment, VRE, Virtual Recorder, a media device that recreates a location in virtual reality by simultaneously recording video, audio, and environmental data from various sensors, then analyzing and compiling the data on a computer. Originally used in planetary exploration and locating mineral deposits. The data, recorded on separate sub-devices, is linked in a virtual editor. This is called virtual processing. Going beyond simply recording 2D or 3D images, a virtual recorder simulates a location perfectly, including not just the materials objects are made of, but even smells, ambient temperature, and humidity. However, virtual processing requires a considerable amount of time, even with the speed of computers available today. BBC has several virtual editors at its studios. Life sciences. Oh, brother. This is going to be rough. Aplastic anemia. God. I'm not going to know how to say half this stuff. A disease in which damage to a person's poietic stem cells, the cells responsible for creating new blood, causes their bone marrow function to decrease, which results in lower production of red blood cells, white blood cells, and megakaryocytes, the precursor to blood platelets. This can lead to anemia, increased risk of hemorrhaging and bruising, and frequent infections due to a weakened immune system. Exposure to radiation, chemical additives, or industrial chemicals such as pesticides are some of the known causes. It can also be triggered as a side effect of certain drugs. Approximately 20% of sufferers die within the first year. Many residents of Beyond Coast suffer from secondary aplastic anemia as a result of radiation exposure. Others on the colony, where drug injuries are common, have developed this disease due to a side effect of prescription drugs. Is considered one of the most problematic diseases of the 21st century and has received special classification on Earth. There is a movement that seeks to get aplastic anemia officially designated one of the diseases of outer space, or diseases of which there is a higher incidence of those not living on Earth. For the past several years, repatriatists have pursued legal action against the ISPA and the Beyond Coast government regarding this classification of this disease. Artificial blood, a type of blood developed to improve the oxygen and other nutrient transportation efficiency of blood, as well as to provide a solution to the lack of blood available for transfusions. Based mainly on substances such as perfluorocarbons and fluorescein diacetate, which were used in the latter half of the 20th century for storing organs. It is also called milk blood because its red blood cells are white in color. Though it does possess superior oxygen transportation efficiency and regenerative abilities, the strain it places on the kidneys makes it necessary for them to be genetically modified and for the user to undergo regular hemodialysis in order for it to be used for extended periods of time. For these reasons, it is not permitted for use by the general public. It is currently only used by members of the military and BCP's AP unit. In addition to milk blood, there is a second-generation powder type made with genetically modified hemoglobin, and a third-generation type containing 100% artificial blood cells, but both types are still undergoing clinical trials. A person using artificial blood has their original blood placed in cryogenic storage and can switch back to it at any time. Interesting. Artificial organ. Any one of a group of man-made organs developed as replacements for human organs such as the heart and the kidneys. Artificial organs designed for permanent use currently do not exist. They are mainly used in bridge to transplants as temporary replacements until a donor can be found. There are hybrid organs in development that combine organic tissue with synthetic materials, but creating fully functional replacements for organs such as the pancreas and the liver remains challenging. Biodegradable plastic. A type of plastic that breaks down into hydrogen, oxygen, and carbon within 1 to 2 weeks when mixed with compost. The accumulation of plastic materials in landfills had been a problem since the latter half of the 20th century until the development of this plastic at the beginning of the 21st. We're still waiting for that, as far as I know, anyway. Do we have biodegradable plastic? I don't know. Modern biodegradable plastic is made primarily out of a lactic acid polymer, with the lactic acid obtained by fermenting various starches. It can then be injection molded or processed into film or fiber. Now, I'm saying we do have biodegradable plastic. It's probably hardly used at all. It's probably expensive as hell. It has simultaneously solved the waste disposal problem and the oxygen replenishment problem on Beyond Coast, with all products required to be made out of biodegradable plastic if possible. Bioethics. Compound noun of Greek origin, bios, meaning life, and ethikos, meaning moral philosophy. An academic study that emerged as a distinct field in the 1960s, the purposes of which being to examine how advances in science impact perception on the value of life and to create ways for society to respond to these advances, involves numerous disciplines such as life sciences, medical treatment, nursing, law, politics, economics, philosophy, theology, religion, ethics, literature, and the arts. Biohazard. An organism or substance hazardous to human beings and or other organisms. An experimentation in biotechnology has... As experimentation in biotechnology has progressed, the chances of a harmful organism, genetically modified or not, escaping into the general population have increased. Laboratories on Earth have established strict isolation protocols, but even so, there have been calls for all such experimentation to be moved to outer space. See my Stasis and Kane playthroughs for stuff about biotechnology and manipulating biomes and stuff. Not biomes, but biological beings. Splicing things with other things and making horrible... Yeah, it's a much darker game than this. Making horrible stuff. Biomechanics. A field of science that studies the flight mechanisms of animals and plants and applies these findings to engineering. Many organisms possess mechanisms that allow them to fly extremely long distances while expending only minute amounts of energy. This science uses these discoveries to advance man-made flight. The flight mechanisms used in EMPS and mosquitoes were created with technology developed in this field. Mosquitoes. Oh my god, there's so much. Mosquitoes over here. Okay. Biomort. A person who is brain dead. Oh, makes sense. Some medical professionals distinguish between a biomort and a neomort, or someone who has recently become brain dead. Different from a person in a persistent vegetative state where only the cerebral cortex has stopped functioning, with a biomort, it is the brainstem, the body's own life support system, which is no longer functioning. The cells of a biomort can be kept alive by giving it hormones or drugs such as vasopressors, and also by connecting it to artificial organs such as an artificial respirator. At the end of the 20th century, the criteria for determining brain death varied from country to country, region to region, but a worldwide consensus for establishing brain death was finally reached with the beginning of the second space age in the early 21st century. Black poppy. A so-called bio poppy developed through genetic modification of the opium poppy, traditionally valued for medicinal and ornamental purposes, used to make the semi-synthetic drug narc, offering a high-potency opium extract. Although its petals are purple, the black spots on its pods have earned it its name. It is said that one would need a specialized facility with advanced technology to cultivate such a genetically modified and delicate species of plant. Yet, we're looking at it. Nevertheless, governments have gone to great lengths to ban all black poppy cultivation. We found out that's what that leaf was from. Trying to figure out how it's connected to the capsules that we have. Bone marrow transplantation. A treatment for blood diseases such as leukemia, aplastic anemia, malignant lymphoma, and various immunodeficiency diseases, whereby bone marrow stem cells are taken from a donor and implanted into a recipient, allowing them to once again produce healthy blood, was previously used to counteract the decrease in bone marrow function that can occur as a side effect of cancer treatments. The procedure involves killing off the recipient's diseased hematopoietic stem cells. I do not know how to say the end of that word. Poietic? The cells responsible for creating new blood with radiation and replacing them with the donor's healthy marrow. However, if the donor and recipient do not possess matching HLA types, severe rejection will occur following the transplant. There are once numerous cases of transplant rejection occurring even when HLA types matched, resulting in low success rates, but these have since risen considerably by giving the recipient substances such as biological proteins before the procedure, thereby reducing the occurrence of such reactions. This is a long one. It was previously necessary to remove approximately 1 liter of stem cells directly from the donor's femur, which required hospitalization and anesthesia, but it is now possible to extract stem cells from the bloodstream or what is known as peripheral blood stem cell transplantation. Following extraction, the stem cells are cultured in a laboratory. This type of transplant has also virtually eliminated accidental injuries during procedures. Bridge to transplant. Come in, transplant. Okay. A method of temporarily extending a person's life through artificial or animal organs until a matching organ donor can be found. There are many cases of patients whose lives have been extended through the use of large-sized artificial organs as replacements for failed organs. Almost all artificial organs are still neither small nor durable and are therefore used mainly as a stopgap measure. Circadian rhythm. The natural internal clock all organisms possess refers to daily biological rhythm. Monthly and seasonal rhythms are classified as biorhythms. If a person's circadian rhythm is disturbed, this can have various negative effects on the body. All space colonies, stations, and bases establish a day-night cycle to help inhabitants maintain their circadian rhythm. On Beyond Coast, this even includes creating the illusions of dawn and dusk, to which organisms are known to be sensitive. Okay, I need a drink. And I'm running out of drink. Cluster transplantation. A transplant method whereby several organs rather than just one are transplanted en bloc. There are numerous cases of elderly recipients requiring multiple organ transplants. By transplanting organs such as the stomach, the duodenum, the small intestine, and the colon together, rejection caused by the transplantation of organs from multiple donors can be avoided. Cold sleep. An artificial sleep, induced by lowering the body's temperature and having it expend only the minimum amount of energy necessary to sustain itself. Yeah, I wonder if this was what our, protagonist, Jonathan, where he was for 25 years. But who found him? Who put him into that stasis? Is that word again? And, why? Why not bring him right to Earth? I don't know. Were they people from Earth? Or beyond? Or aliens? As controlling the body's temperature is extremely difficult, this method requires a special capsule equipped with an electronic freezing device. Post-thaw muscle atrophy, among other issues, was a problem with early cold sleep techniques, but this has been overcome through studying the hibernation of bears. Thus, cold sleep is now known as hibernation. However, because certain aspects of cold sleep, namely its safety, remain unproven, it has yet to be permitted for official use. Astronauts are therefore forced to endure long-distance space flights without this luxury, a fact that has contributed to the spread of illegal drugs throughout space. Does this have to do with the accident that Jonathan was in? I forget what year that was. The Yuri, because he was in a Yuri suit. The Yuri involved in the Yuri accident of 2013 was tethered to an early version of the Survival Ball Cold Sleep Unit. The accident proved to be valuable test data for cold sleep, helping to improve the technology. Here we go. Jonathan Ingram's 25 years is the record for the longest amount of time a person has spent in cold sleep. 25 years. So 2038. And it's I think it's now, it's 2040, I believe. So his suit was tethered to an early version of the Survival Ball Cold Sleep Unit. So what do you do, just orbit the Earth or something for a while? And then they came upon him? I want to find out how he was discovered. That might answer our question, though. I mean, it almost says it right there. It doesn't say it was him, specifically. You notice that, though. So, I don't know. Cosmic ray exposure. Cosmic rays, or particles of extremely high energy constantly moving through outer space, can have various effects on the human body. Sudden exposure to large doses of cosmic radiation can cause widespread cellular birth or even total body surface area burns, but it poses a danger to anyone exposed of it, regardless of dose or length of time. A comprehensive investigation into the extent of this threat did not begin until mankind had already started colonizing space, and is now the most significant problem of long-distance space travel and space construction. Beyond COS has taken preventative measures to combat cosmic radiation, such as the creation of solar flare broadcasts and shield warnings, but in reality, the effects of this radiation exposure on space colonists continue to grow. It is said that exposure to cosmic radiation can cause flashing lights to appear in one's field of vision, a warning sign similar to a symptom of optic neuritis. Cosmophobia, a fear of outer space. The darkness, cramped environments, and restricted access to oxygen experienced when in outer space can, either instantaneously or over time, trigger extreme unrest or panic in some people, and in severe cases can even lead to breathing difficulties or cardiac arrest. It is commonly reported among astronauts participating in long-distance flights and long-term space facility workers. Cosmophobia is one of the reasons use of narc and other illegal drugs has become so widespread in space, and one of the most fundamental issues to future deep space exploration is how to overcome such psychological hurdles. Jonathan Ingram suffers from cosmophobia as a result of his EMPS accident. Cyposloidine. An immunosuppressive drug developed by Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals. Able to completely suppress organ transplant rejection, it led to the widespread adoption of organ transplantation. Unlike previous immunosuppressive drugs, it contained no side effects and only acted on transplanted organs. Widely used until the development of transplant technology that prevents rejection, such as mast transplantation. Defense wound. An injury, such as scratches, bruising, or bleeding, sustained by the victim of an attack as a result of trying to defend against the attacker. Indicative of homicide, one of its uses is to distinguish between acts of homicide and suicide. Interesting. Designer foods. A food containing vitamins and or certain approved chemical additives which has the same effect as a drug. Like functional foods, the most popular designer foods are calcium-related products calcium being easily lost in outer space. DNA fingerprinting. A method of identifying a person from a DNA sample. Blood and other bodily fluids, hair, or even bones can be used in this process. Except for identical twins, every person's DNA sequence is unique, making identification through this method conclusive. DNA can be extracted from as little as 2 to 5 microliters of blood or a single strand of hair, for example. Donor. A person who donates one or more of their organs or tissue to a recipient. With the development of immunosuppressive drugs and transplant technology that prevents rejection, the dangers of organ transplants have been reduced while their possibilities have expanded. Diseases and ailments caused by living in outer space have led to increased demand for organs on Beyond Coast and other space colonies and bases. However, a severe donor shortage is forcing researchers to develop new ways to prolong the lives of those waiting for a transplant. Artificial organs are presently being used in bridge to transplants, and with animal organs or xenotransplantation is also being studied. Organizations like the ISPA are trying to combat the donor shortage by persuading space facilities to join the worldwide organ and tissue donor network. Drug identification code. Oh, we just learned about this last episode. A mark or code, or the one before actually, a mark or code printed on a drug or its packaging to differentiate it from other products. Each pharmaceutical company has its own identification codes, with most codes now holographic. There are also drugs whose code changes color once the drug is expired in order to alert the user. That's really handy. I'd say that some of this stuff is in our future, I swear. I'm not saying the next 5 to 10 years, but further down the line. Maybe in the real 2040. Drug profit margin. The difference in price between what the consumer pays for a drug and what the vendor pays for it. When a consumer buys a drug, they are charged a set price for it. However, in a free market economy, the vendor of the drug, such as the pharmacy, is able to obtain most drugs from pharmaceutical companies at a discount. The profit that pharmaceutical companies and doctors earn from this system has long been the subject of controversy. Yeah, it still is. It is said that one of the reasons for Tokugawa Pharmaceutical's success can be attributed to it introducing this system of high drug prices seen before in post-war Japan to Beyond Coast. The problems of the high drug profit margin and over-prescription of drugs have been quietly talked about among medical professionals in recent years, but pressure from Tokugawa has prevented the enactment of reforms. This profiteering has been criticized by some on Earth, with Beyond labeled as a colony of drug victims. This delicate situation makes a separation of Beyond Coast's medical industry unlikely for the foreseeable future. Frozener. A person created from an artificially fertilized egg held in cryogenic storage by a government, which is later transferred to a surrogate mother for gestation and delivery. A frozener's egg is inserted with genetic information that makes the individual better adapted to space's environment, allowing them to endure a wide range of activities in space that would give a normal person great difficulty. Since frozeners are legally in a class of their own, they are tattooed with an identification code on their forehead. Frozeners are common on Beyond Coast and are not discriminated against in any way by other Beyonds. Many are employed by the military or work in government positions. Frozeners call the government, which raises them, the breeders. It is rumored they are also given anti-aging treatment through telomere lengthening. I recently read about that. Telomere lengthening? Telomere, yeah. Functional foods. A food designed to help prevent various adult diseases and diseases associated with obesity, as well as to delay the aging process and help regulate the body's functions. Many of the functional foods found on Beyond Coast are for replacing lost calcium. They combine an appealing taste with the proper amount of vitamins and minerals necessary to maintain an overall healthy body function. Products that meet the special standards established on Beyond for functional foods receive the label a recognized Beyond functional food. G biology. A newly established field of space life science that attempts to crack mysteries of life by examining the functional relationships between gravity and organisms. Sounds mysterious. Hemodialysis. The process of using a machine instead of the kidneys to filter a person's blood. previously used as renal replacement therapy for people with end-stage renal failure or acute renal failure, it has lately come into use by those employing artificial blood, which would overwhelm ordinary human kidneys. The process involves a semi-permeable membrane, part of the dialyzer, usually made out of cellophane. Blood is circulated on one side of the membrane while dialysis fluid, is circulated on the other side. Waste products pass through the membrane into the dialysate and out of the body. The subject is given a continuous infusion of low molecular weight heparin during dialysis to prevent blood clots from forming in a dialyzer, but too much heparin can stop all blood clotting as a result of heparin-induced post-dialysis thrombocytopenia or a low platelet count. Jesus. AP members use hemodialysis to filter their artificial blood, and due to the thinning of the blood caused by the heparin, when a member is cut, they lose close to twice as much blood as an ordinary person. Really? However, new dialysis floods are being developed. I can't even say normal words now because of all this. However, new dialysis fluids are being developed to counteract this. Every AP's computer console and bed are fitted with their own dialysis machine that is on standby 24 hours per day. HLA. Acronym. That's not under acronyms, though. Human leukocyte antigen. Histocompatibility antigens are proteins used by the immune system to differentiate self cells from non-self cells. The system of histocompatibility antigens found in humans is collectively called HLA, with one's HLA genes determining one's HLA type. HLA proteins can be found on the surface of all cells except for red blood cells, and if a transplant recipient receives an organ or tissue with a different HLA type, this will cause rejection, whereby the body will attack the cells of the graft organ or tissue, which it considers an invader. There are numerous antigens and virtually millions of possible HLA types due to the nature in which they are inhibited from one's parents. HLA types are particularly important with regard to bone marrow transplants. Histocompatibility tissue tests are conducted to determine whether a donor and a recipient share an HLA type. This is done by examining the lymphocytes in the subject's blood. ICU. Yeah, I knew about this stuff. I mean, it's probably more advanced than this, but intensive care unit, also known as a cocoon. See, this doesn't appear in acronyms. A hospital ward designed to monitor the bodily functions, including breathing and circulation, of critically injured or post-operative patients. A patient can be monitored around the clock here with an artificial respirator to assist or replace spontaneous breathing, an electrocardiogram for observing heart function, and various systems for replenishing bodily fluids and providing the body with nutrients. The ICU also allows hospital staff to respond immediately to a sudden worsening of a patient's condition. Furthermore, an ICU allows a patient to be isolated in a sterile environment for extended periods of time should they develop an immunodeficiency disease. Their waste products can be removed, they can be provided nourishment through intravenous tubes, and their body can be cleaned, all while remaining in protective isolation. Methodology and technology created through the development of spacesuits, cold sleep pods, and monitoring systems for the elderly have been applied to the ICU over the years to the point where it is now semi-automated. Yeah, everything was pretty much like how we know it until methodology and technology, etc. BCCH boasts the largest and most advanced ICU on Beyond Coast. The hospital has been designated one of the colony's emergency response facilities. Intraocular lens. An artificial lens substituting the eye's own crystalline lens inserted inside the eye and serving the same function. Intraocular lenses make the user's eyesight 2 or 3 times superior to that of a person without them, and the user is also able to tolerate variations in water or air pressure. In addition to offering better vision, intraocular lenses provide a more natural refractive index than glasses or contact lenses, reducing physical and mental strain on the user. All AP members have intraocular lenses to aid them in their work, which demands superior eyesight. Originally developed to protect the eyesight of people working in extreme areas. Masked transplantation. A transplant method whereby the graft does not affect the recipient's immune system, performed by masking the organ's class 1 HLA genes with antibody fragments before transplantation. This method has eliminated the occurrence of rejection with organ transplants, previously their biggest problem. The development of mass transplantation, in addition to ending the age of Tokugawa's revolutionary immunosuppressive drug cyposlodine, greatly improved the image of organ transplants as well. Mosquito. A micro-machine medical robot jointly developed by Tokugawa Heavy Industries and Pharmaceuticals, a portmanteau of the words mass, public, and mosquito. Designed to resemble and behave like the mosquito, it was developed for use in drawing blood from people and animals, as well as for administering shots. It is also being studied for possible use as a replacement for biological pesticides, since it would no doubt disturb a coeles. However, a series of accidents and ethical questions have prevented it from being officially permitted for any use. Rather than serve the medical world, the mosquito has helped advance micro-machine technology. Speaking of which, there's micro-machine. Medical industry separation. A medical system in which a doctor makes a diagnosis and writes a prescription that is then filled separately by a pharmacist. Under this system, there must be a consensus between a doctor and the pharmacist regarding the prescription, which helps prevent doctors from over-prescribing drugs. Yeah, I don't know if pharmacists, at least in the U.S., I don't think pharmacists have any say over it. They'll just fill it. There is a growing number of people calling for this system to be implemented on space colonies where over-prescription is common. Micro-machine. A micro-sized machine, several hundredths of 1 millimeter to several centimeters in size, composed of micro-sized mechanical parts and drive mechanisms. So like a nano-machine. Examples include various micro-sized medical robots, the Mosquito, developed by Tokugawa, etc., is a type of micro-machine. A more common type of similar machine is a nano-machine. There we go. Its use of organic parts allowing it to be even smaller than a micro-machine. Okay. Narc. A semi-synthetic narcotic that is part natural, part synthetic, part hallucinogen, engineered through supercomputer-aided drug design. Made by combining opium produced from black poppy pods with a pethidine-based synthetic drug, and to this adding a hallucinogen containing lysergic acid derivatives obtained from ergot alkaloids. Mixing this potent genetically modified opium extract with a chemical structure non-existent in the natural world produces narcotic and hallucinogenic effects never before seen with any drug. Once popular mainly among astronauts seeking to relieve the psychological strain of outer space activity, it spread quickly with the start of long-distance space flights and the completion of bases on the Moon and Mars, with users looking for a way to cope with extended periods of time in space. The drug is so potent that even a few milligrams can be fatal. This makes it difficult to detect in drug tests, as users take it in extremely small doses, meaning it does not become very concentrated in the body. Narc also attaches to opioid peptides, natural opiates produced by the body, doubling the effects of the morphine it contains. It has been speculated that the Mafia is responsible for Narc. Nearly 20% of adults on the Beyond Coast have tried at least one illegal drug, a rate second only to the United States, still fighting its war on drugs. Yes, we sure are. Osmotic pressure design. A pharmaceutical design that uses an osmotic pressure to evenly distribute a controlled amount of a substance throughout the human body, even in weightlessness. Employed in products such as Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals' K9 DDS. Outer Space Medical Examination System. OSMES. A system established to help prevent pathogens from entering a closed environment such as a space colony or a base. All spaceports are staffed by specialist doctors who perform a full space medical exam on all arriving people. P300 Lie Detector. Really? lie detector that analyzes the P300 brainwave, which is larger when a person sees an object, person, or location they have personally experienced. On Earth, the use of this lie detector, along with brain imaging techniques such as MRI, has become an important form of evidence at trials. Yeah, it's not used as evidence in trials. Science has unlocked many previously unsolved mysteries of the human brain, with criminal justice systems starting to adopt a more psychological approach as a result. Yeah, it's not admissible in trials. Maybe they thought so back in 94, but now, no. Poggendorf illusion. An optical illusion discovered by German scientist Johann Christian Poggendorf in 1860. He observed that the two ends of a diagonal line appear out of alignment when the line is intersected by an obscuring rectangle. What that has to do with anything. Prodrug. A type of DDS consisting of a drug in its inactive form that is converted into its active form in vivo by metabolic processes. By making a drug with particularly severe side effects into a prodrug, harmful effects on other areas of the body can be reduced. In contrast, antidrugs become inactive after leaving the target area. Psychiatric nurse. A nurse who provides psychiatric care to patients who are mentally ill, terminally ill, or undergoing long-term treatment. In helping patients combat an illness, psychiatric nurses have been proven to play a key role in addition to the actual physical development. Physical treatment. Sorry. Rebirther. A human being cloned from the DNA of a historical figure, often an actress or supermodel. Really? The law prohibits anyone from rebirthing a person until 20 years after their death. Why is it then suddenly legal? While identical on a genetic level, a rebirther is not considered the same person as the original, and the law now requires that rebirthers be differentiated from the original by placing identification tags on the rebirther's chromosomes. You can put an ID tag on someone's chromosome? Although rebirthers are not very common, some can be found within the Tokugawa group. Such individuals are legally regarded as members of the Tokugawa family. Recipient of a donor. Yeah, organ. A person who receives an organ or tissue from a donor. The incidence of diseases and organ abnormalities caused by the harsh environments of outer space is increasing rapidly, with the number of people waiting to receive healthy organs or tissue rising proportionally. Return syndrome. A syndrome characterized by the desire to return to Earth. Frequently observed among middle-aged terrestrials living on Beyond Coast, almost all missing person cases on Beyond are instances of return syndrome. The exact cause remains unclear, but it is only reported among Beyonds who grew up on Earth, particularly those who took part in the first or second waves of immigration. Some have speculated it is caused by the constant stress of living in outer space, with the individual developing an extreme version of homesickness. Many of those who experience return syndrome later say they became filled with a sudden urge to return to Earth, or go home, and departed on the next available flight to Earth without so much as informing their family. SAS, Space Adaptation Syndrome. A type of temporary sickness caused by exposure to a weightless environment. It is said that the cause of SAS is a vestibular disorder, whereby the vestibular system undergoes a paralysis, causing one to lose one's sense of balance. Symptoms include dizziness, cold sweats, headache, fatigue, vomiting, and, in particular, a false feeling of falling over that does not equate with ordinary motion sickness. The most effective treatment is an intramuscular promethazine injection. Conversely, the symptoms exposed when moving from a zero-G environment to a 1G environment are collectively called Earth Adaptation Syndrome. Selective mutism. An anxiety disorder observed primarily in children in which the individual chooses not to speak due to a psychological reason. Sometimes the individual attempts to speak but their articulators freeze and they are unable to produce sound. Really? Surrogate mother. A woman who carries and delivers a baby created from an egg fertilized in vitro, often for financial compensation. Although surrogate mothers have no parental rights, many end up wanting to raise the baby as their own. Opinion is divided on using surrogate mothers for giving birth to frozeners. As development of an artificial womb has yet to be completed, however, there is currently no alternative. Transplant coordinator. a person who works with organ or tissue donors and recipients, helping to arrange speedy transplants for patients, also called a transplant manager. There are currently over 4,000 transplant coordinators on Beyond Coast. There's a lot here about organ transplant. Ultra-high pressure sterilization. A sterilization method that uses extremely high pressure to kill microorganisms. Developed as an alternative to heat sterilization, which can change an object's composition or even destroy it. This method allows for perishable foods to be stored over longer periods of time while maintaining freshness. It is particularly valued on Beyond Coast, whose inhabitants consume large amounts of fruits and vegetables. Also now used to sterilize medical equipment and waste, and part of infection control systems in hospitals. Four more, and we'll call an episode, a long episode. Viroid S, the smallest known pathogen composed of single strands of RNA, which invades plant cells and can cause disease. Containing no protein coats, viroids infect mainly crop plants, with viroid S only infecting Papaviridae, or the poppy family. It spread throughout Beyond Coast in 2035, wiping out all poppy cultivation. It has never been reported on Earth, leading some to speculate is a mutated version of an Earth viroid. Called viroid S because its structure resembles the letter S of the Latin alphabet. Vital reaction. A response of a living organism to trauma. If trauma, such as bruising or bleeding, occurs before the organism's death, this affects the injury's presentation. In forensic pathology, vital reactions are used to determine if a body was tampered with after death. Xenotransplantation. A procedure that transplants an animal organ or tissue into a human. One of the most common examples is the use of pig hearts that have been spliced with human DNA. With the development of new transplant techniques, there is less danger of the animal passing on an infection to the recipient. However, they are used more often as a bridge to transplant than as a permanent replacement. Many organizations and industries oppose such transplants on ethical grounds, and they have not been approved by the Beyond Coast Development, nor does it fund any research in the field. There are numerous documented cases of this type of transplant, such as the transplantation of baboon livers into humans at the end of the 20th century. Wow. And finally, zero-G ward. A hospital ward that treats patients in zero gravity. Treating patients with, for example, a herniated disc, repetitive strain injury, or myasthenia gravis in weightlessness. Actually, you know what that is. Thus, avoiding the stress bones and muscles experience under normal gravity has offered new ways of treating conditions previously difficult to treat. This method is also used for treating people who have become bedridden or have high percentage burns. Most of the patients treated here are terrestrials, as conditions such as these occur far more frequently in terrestrials than in beyonds. And on that note, all we have left to check out is outer space, society, and technology. I'm wondering if we can wrap that up in one last episode, at least for now. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Well, yeah, we're going to be reading more of this. Should be done with the bulk of it. Thanks so much for watching, and always, seek adventure.